Well, hello everyone. Now, first of all, I think we're going to go back to the 3 days a week like we were. I didn't want to do that until the formatting and everything was taken care of, but it's a sticky situation when you start playing that game, and I'm still actually working on the format. So anyway, that being said, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, just like usual, and let's get right into the news. Now, fairly local to me, about actually 30 minutes away from me in Lodi, apparently at the farmer's market, a woman had sent in a letter to the editor of the Lodi Sentinel complaining that her son was playing in the bounce house. When she walked around the back of the bounce house to get in the shade, she saw another child with a snake wrapped around his arm, I guess letting its head kind of roam around near the bounce house, and she is calling for reptiles to, I guess, be banned from the farmer's market. Now, she has an obvious fear of reptiles, and I've got the letter on the link on the website, so you can read it as well. And of course, all the comments are anti-person, pro-reptile, telling her to get over her fear, and there's no reason why somebody should enact legislation because of somebody's personal fear. Now, moving right along, this is a story that came out, I guess it's like a week or week and a half ago, or maybe. A man from Michigan out camping lost his boa. I guess he forgot to zip up his backpack and the boa got out. They are saying that he was given a ticket for having an animal at large and he could be forced to pay restitution for search efforts, which actually failed. And it only really begs one question. Why did you take your boa camping? Which is going to lead us right to our question of the day. Have you ever taken one of your snakes camping? If so, why? Leave a text comment or a video response. And moving on. Researchers are apparently coming out with some more good stuff. Medicines taken from reptiles are saying that the protein in the saliva and tail of Gila monsters helps type 2 diabetes. They're saying that people, it's a whole big thing with apparently they overeat, they get overweight, that produces fattier cells that are apparently more immune to the insulin, and apparently this protein helps make the body more sensitive to the insulin and fight type 2 diabetes. So that's awesome. Again, it's an awesome article. The protein is exenatide. I think I could be mispronouncing that. It wouldn't be the first time. So go read the article. It's an awesome article. It's, reptiles helping unhealthy humans to live longer and healthier. And to get a little bit of more research and some good news for snake bite victims, the World Health Organization estimates that 100,000 people globally per year are killed by venomous snakes. However, researchers in Australia find that a medicine normally used for heart patients and stuff, nitrous oxide, may actually raise the chances of somebody surviving. They're saying that it cuts the spread of the venom up to 50% when administered after a snake bite, giving the person the extra time they may need to go seek medical treatment. That being said, we do have a winner for the free Ban Stupid Not Snakes t-shirt, and that is on YouTube, Nerd Flavored Condom. That's a funny username. I'll put a link right down here somewhere. Anyway, go tell them congratulations. If you are watching this, which you probably are, judging from what you said in your video response, then I've sent you a message asking for your address and size so I could send that shirt. So as soon as you get back to me, it'll be on its way. And thank you. Anyway, that has been all your news. And like I said, bear with me while programming and formatting may change here and there, but back to Monday, Wednesday, Friday starting today. So that has been all your news for today. If you'd like to read any more of these stories, those links are right down below here in the description. And as always, if you're still watching, my name is Jason White, and now you know what's going on in the reptile world. Be good to each other, and we'll see you on Wednesday.